Namaskar. Dear viewers, welcome to NIOS Studio. Myself, Dr. Yogesh Sharma from Ramgadhia College of Education, Phagwada. Today, we are going to discuss standard deviation. It is a topic in Pedagogy of Mathematics 504. The measures of dispersion. Although indexes of central tendency help us to describe data in terms of average value or typical measures, they do not give the total picture of distribution. The mean value of two distributions may be identical, whereas the degree of dispersion or variability of their scores might be different. In one distribution, the scores might cluster around the central value. In the other, they might be scattered. For illustration, consider the following distribution of scores. In A distribution, the scores are 24, 24, 25, 25, 26, and 26. Whereas in B distribution, the scores are 16, 19, 22, 25, 28, 30, and 35. If we compute mean of both of these distributions, the mean will be 25 each, but that does not show the total picture. The value of mean in both distribution is 25, but degree of scattering of scores differs considerably. The scores in distribution A are obviously much more homogeneous than those in distribution B. There is clearly a need of indexes that can describe distribution in terms of variation, spread, dispersion, heterogeneity, or scatter of scores. For those we have measures of dispersion. Measures of dispersion characterize how spread out the distribution is, that is, how variable the data are. Dispersion is the extent to which values in a distribution differ from average of the distribution. To quantify the extent of the variation, there are certain measures, namely range, quartile deviation, mean deviation or average deviation, and standard deviation. Standard deviation is defined as root mean square deviation, as it is the square root of means of the square deviations from arithmetic mean. Standard deviation is the measure of dispersion of a set of data from its mean. It measures the absolute variability of a distribution. The higher the dispersion or variability, the greater is the standard deviation, and greater will be magnitude of the deviation of the value from their mean. The concept of standard deviation was introduced by Carl Pearson in 1893. It is by far the most important and widely used measure of dispersion. Its significance lies in the fact that it is free from those defects which afflicted earlier methods like range, quartile deviation, and mean deviation, and satisfies most of the properties of a good measure of dispersion. It is known as best measure of dispersion or variability. Standard deviation shows the variation in data. If the data is close together, the standard deviation will be small. If the data is spread out, the deviation will be large. Standard deviation is often denoted by lowercase letter that is called sigma. The standard deviation formula in case of ungrouped data, this can be written as by the notation that is sigma is equal to over n, where m is arithmetic mean, n is total number of observations. There are certain steps to find standard deviation in case of ungrouped data. First of all, the mean of the data has to be found out. Then subtract the mean from each value. Third is square each deviation of the mean. D, find the sum of the squares. Then fifth part is divide the total by number of items and then take the square root of the variance. We will like to do an example for that. Here we have certain values 9, 4, 5 and 6. We need to compute standard deviation of this data. First of all, we compute mean. For mean, we have formula summation x over n, or we can say sigma x over n. Summation x is 9 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 over, here n is total number of observations and the number of observations are 4. This will come out to be 9 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6, this will come out to be 24 by 4 and this will, sorry, 24 by 4 and this will come out to be 6. Now we will take deviations from the mean. X, M, X minus M and X minus M square. Here values are 9, 4, 5 and 6. The mean is 6, 6, 6 and 6. Already we have computed the mean. Now, what is x minus m? This will come out to be 3 minus 2, x minus 2, 4 minus 6 minus 2, 5 minus 6 minus 1 and 6 minus 6, 0. We will take square of this in the next column. 3 square 9, 4, 1 and 0. The sigma x minus m square we need, this will come out to be 14. So the standard deviation sigma, this is equal to under root sigma x minus m square over n. This will come out to be 14 over n, where n we have 4 square root. This will come out to be square root 14 over 2 and this, the value come out to be, if we will calculate, it will come out to be 1.87. This is a way with which we can compute standard deviation in case of ungrouped data. Now, how to compute standard deviation in case of grouped data? Find mean of the set of data M. Second, find difference between each value and mean, that is X minus M. Next is square the difference, X minus M whole square. Multiply square of difference by corresponding frequency, F into X minus M whole square. Add up these values, that is sigma F X minus M whole square. Find the average of these values, sigma F X minus M whole square over N, and then take the square root of this to find standard deviation. Now, we will compute standard deviation in case of group data. The classes, first we will write class interval. In the second column, we will write frequency F, then mid value, that is X, the class intervals are 10 to 20, 20 to 30, it can be 30 to 50, 50 to 70, and 70 to 80. The corresponding frequencies are 5, 8, 16, 8, and 3. If we will compute sigma f, or this is equal to n, this will come out to be 40. Now next is mid value, which is called x, capital X. The mid value will be this plus this divided by 2, 15. This plus this, 20 plus 30 divided by 2, 25. 30 plus 50, 80 divided by 2, 40. 50 plus 70 divided by 2 come out to be 60, and then it is 75. Now our next step is to compute f into x, that is f multiply by x, f multiply by x. This will come out to be 75, 200, 16 into 40, 640, 8 into 60, it will come out to be 480, 3 into 75, 225, and sigma fx will be equal to 1 summation of that, add with that, and by adding we will get 1620. Now we want to compute mean. For that we have a formula for mean, sigma f x over n. This is equal to 1620 over 40, and it will come out to be 40.5. It will come out to be 45. From this mean, we will take certain deviations, that is x minus m. X minus m, 15 minus 40.5. 15 minus 40.5, that will come out to be minus 25.5. Then x minus m, 25 minus 40.5, minus 15.5. Similarly, the values of x minus m will be minus 0.5, 19.5, and 75 minus 40.5, 34.5. Now, next we have two more steps. One, we have to compute x minus m whole square, and then we will multiply. Then, now we have to repeat. Now we have two more steps. One, we will compute x minus m whole square, and then we will multiply f with x minus m whole square. Now, what is x minus m square? That is minus 25.5 the whole square. That is minus 25.5 into minus 25.5. That will come out to be 650.25. Minus 15.5, this will come out to be 240.25. then minus 0.5 into minus 0.5, that will come out to be 0.25, and then this will come out to be 380.25, and then 34.5 multiply by 34.5, 1190.25. So we have x minus m square. Now we multiply x minus m whole square with f. We have f5, we have x minus m this. We will multiply f with this and write the value here. That will come out to be 3251.25 f into x minus m square 1922 f into x minus m square 4 f into x minus m square 3042, and then last 3570.75, and sum of this is 3sigma f into x minus m the whole square. Now from here we can easily compute standard deviation by putting that value in the formula of standard deviation. The standard deviation will come out to be sigma fx minus m square over n. This will come out to be 11790 over n is 40, and we will solve this, and by solving this we will get the value of standard deviation, which will be 17.17. So it is very easy. If we need to revise it, first we have some class intervals, we have some frequency, we will compute mid value, this plus this divided by 2, 15, this plus this divided by 2, 25, this plus this divided by 2, 40. Then we will multiply f with x and we will find sigma fx. From sigma fx and n, we can find mean. Sigma fx over n, this is equal to 1620 divided by 40.5. Now with the use of this, we can compute x minus m. x minus m, the value will be minus 20.5.5, and like that we can get all the x minus m values. Then we can find x minus m squares, and last step is f into x minus m square. When we get f into x minus m square, we will get summation of that, and in the last we will put these values in the formula and easily we can get standard deviation. This is how we can compute standard deviation. Now we have another method of computing standard deviation from a shortcut method. That shortcut method is, we have class intervals, we have frequencies, then from mid values, then next we have we calculate d. D is from assumed mean, x minus assumed mean over h. 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. And downward 1, 2, 3, 4. Then next is d square. We will square the value of d square. Then we will compute f into d. And last we will compute f into d square. This is in case of computing standard deviation by shortcut method. We will put the values in a formula, h into sigma f d square over n minus sigma f d square over n. And from here we can compute standard deviation also. Whatever formula we make use, the standard deviation will always come out to be same. Now, what are the merits of standard deviation? Number one, it is rigidly defined and free from any ambiguity. Its calculation is based on all the observations of a series, and it cannot be correctly calculated ignoring any item of a series. Then, it strictly follows the algebraic principles, and it never ignores the plus and minus signs like the mean deviation. It is capable of further algebraic treatment as it has a lot of algebraic properties. Then it is used as a formidable instrument in the making higher statistical analysis in correlation, skewness, regression, and sample studies. It is not much affected by fluctuations in sampling, for which it is widely used in testing the hypothesis, like in case of t-test also. In a normal distribution, x bar plus minus 1 SD covers 68.27% of the value, for which it is called standard measure of dispersion. It exhibits the scatter of dispersion of the various items of a series from its arithmetic mean, and thereby justify its name as a measure of dispersion. It enables us to make comparative study of the two or more series, and it enables us to determine the reliability of the mean of the two or more series when they show the identical means. Like, it can be calculated through a good number of methods yielding the same results, and it has a good number of algebraic properties for which it's possible to determine the number of many connected factors like combined standard deviation of two or more series. There are some demerits also, as its calculation is difficult as it involves many mathematical models and processes. It is affected very much by the extreme values of series, in as much as the squares of deviations of big items proportionately bigger than the squares of smaller items. It cannot be used for comparing the dispersion of two or more series given in different units, and it's not understood by common man. So this is about standard deviation. Today we learned about standard deviation, its merits, its demerits, and how we can compute in case of grouped data, in case of ungrouped data, and with the help of shortcut method. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.